Welcome back to another episode of It's All Clutter. I'm Jess Marcy. I'm a clutter coach, and I approach clutter from a completely integrated standpoint. When we start tackling the physical clutter in your life, we also support you around the emotional clutter, the financial clutter, the relationship clutter, the social clutter. It's all clutter. It's all connected. On this episode of It's All Clutter, I want to talk about what you should be looking for if you are intending on hiring a professional organizer to come into your house and help you declutter. I have five things that you can ask and look for in a future professional who's going to come and work with you that will make the experience really worth your time and money. One of the problems with the professional organizing industry is that there's no standard certification process to become a professional organizer. When I started as a professional organizer, I just told people I was a professional organizer and I built my business up. But along the way, I engaged in a ton of continuing education type activities that were relevant to the experiences I was having with my clients and working with them. I consulted with a tremendous amount of mental health professionals. I relied on my master's degree in archival science, which is essentially the organization of giant historical collections. I talked to experts. I asked questions. I really tried to get answers for things that I felt I could not offer support around when I was going into people's homes and seeing the true impact of clutter in their lives, which is way more than just stuff on the floor. I learned the hard way. I also had a lot of conversations with clients who had already hired a professional organizer who had forced them to throw out stuff or had come into their house and was somewhat bullying. And that actually was a traumatic experience for these clients that set them back on their journey. It pushed them back into this feeling of shame and embarrassment, and actually triggered more clutter coming in. So I want to help you avoid that. For some people, having somebody tell you, get rid of this right now works. But if that is not you, then this video is for you. So the number one thing that you should look for in hiring a professional organizer is, are they coming from a judgment-free spot? Are they coming into your house looking at you as an individual, as the beautiful person that you are, and there to help you? Are they coming from a place of no judgment? Because it is human nature to hoard. That's been an evolutionary advantage for a millennia now. Because it's human nature to hoard, there should be no shame or embarrassment around clutter. And if somebody is going to come into your house and judge you for the environment that you are living in, they are not somebody that you want working with you. When I used to work in people's homes, now I work entirely remotely in group programs online, but when I used to work in people's homes, the first thing I would say right off the bat is, I am completely judgment-free in my approach to dealing with your clutter. I am here to help you. I believe that you have a purpose in this world and that the clutter is holding you back, and I honor the fact that you went out on a limb, made that phone call, and are inviting me into your house. I know how difficult that can be. So number one, are they judgment-free? That's a straight up question that you can ask on the phone. Number two, do they have insurance and references? If they're saying they're a professional organizer, then find out, are they insured? Do they have references? Talk to clients who have worked with them. Has it been a positive experience? Any good professional organizer is gonna be happy, more than willing to share with you references and to show you their insurance. Now, you want somebody working in your house to be insured in case something gets broken or something like that. So they just need general liability insurance. Are they insured? Do they have references? Pretty simple, standard stuff. Question number three, are they going to encourage you to spend money on pretty bins and things to organize your stuff? If they are, I want you to think long and hard about having this person work in your house. The process of decluttering and organizing starts with decluttering. Decluttering does not involve the purchase of anything extra. If you are bringing in bins and boxes to tackle your clutter, you're adding to your clutter. The deeper part of decluttering and organizing is the process of decluttering. It's the guiding you through that process, asking the right questions, being there in a support role, helping you make decisions, not making decisions for you, which is actually my number four question. Are they going to force you to throw things out? Are they going to make decisions for you? Are they going to encourage you to work on stuff in your house that's not your stuff, because that's unethical? But it happens a lot. So are they going to ask you to buy more stuff in the name of organization, which is totally unnecessary, an additional expense and adding to your clutter? And are they going to encourage you to work on your husband's stuff or your kid's stuff or things that are not your collection to deal with? Because that's not the correct approach. That's not ethical. And the thing is, when somebody throws out your stuff, so when somebody forces you to throw out something or when you throw out somebody else's stuff, that can be a traumatic experience that can trigger more clutter. It could also be the reason that you have clutter. So that approach, from an ethical standpoint, I don't agree with. So I would, you know, find out, ask some questions around that. Like, do we work on my stuff? Do we work room by room? Like, how do we do it? And just kind of get some more information there. And finally, I think it would be really helpful to talk to clients who have worked with this organizer several years ago, because a lot of professional organizers are there to implement a system, and systems only work if they are flexible and if they can grow and change. A static system in a dynamic environment is never going to work. So if they're just going to implement a system that's not going to grow and change and be flexible, it's not going to last. So I would love for you to find out if the professional organizer has worked with clients who have been able to maintain their organization for the long term. I have always said to my clients, I don't want to come back here next year because you have added more clutter and you're in the same situation. I want to never see you again. I want you to have such a good experience with me that lasts for the rest of your life. So many mindset shifts, so many habit changes, so much growth in this area that you tell other people about me and I work with them. But I never want to see you as a repeat client ever again, because that means I failed at my job. So find out, do they have repeat clients that come back year after year? Because that's probably not what you're looking for. So those are my top five questions for you to ask when you're looking to hire a professional organizer. I hope this helps and sets you in the right direction and gives you some food for thought around things that you might not have thought about if you hadn't heard this video. If you're interested in taking my foundations course, it's $27, clutterfoundations.com. Learn the basic skills and simple strategies that you need to get started on this path of decluttering for good. I can't wait to see you in one of my groups if you choose to join. Otherwise, find a professional organizer or work with them, because this process can absolutely change your life.